The health department urges local government units to refrain from announcing to the public which vaccines will be offered in specific sites. Health Undersecretary Mirna Kabutahe makes the suggestion Wednesday, May 19, following reports of crowding in sites across Metro Manila for a chance to get Pfizer's vaccine. After the arrival of Pfizer's vaccine in the Philippines on May 10, vaccination sites in Manila and other cities have seen an influx of people lining up to get the limited shots. Meantime, the Okta Research Group calls on the national government to devote 90% of all COVID-19 vaccines to Metro Manila to hasten herd immunity. The group says devoting 90% of vaccine supply to Metro Manila will reduce the number of active COVID-19 cases nationwide by 30%. It also says the remaining 10% of the country's vaccine supply shall go to medical frontliners and senior citizens in the rest of the country. Mathematician Guido David from the Okta Research Group says, while areas outside Metro Manila and Calabarzon are seeing higher case counts, their overall caseloads are not nearly as alarming as Metro Manila's. In related news, the Philippine Hospital Association President Dr. Jaime Almora says hospitals are under severe financial distress. This as PhilHealth fails to fully reimburse hospitals for millions worth of COVID-19 treatments since March 2020. While Almora cannot give a full amount during the hearing, he said PhilHealth has 1.2 billion pesos worth of unpaid debts to one hospital alone. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque clarifies President Rodrigo Duterte's gag order on cabinet members regarding publicly discussing the West Philippine Sea issue. Duterte on Monday, May 17, orders his cabinet to refrain discussing this West Philippine Sea with anybody. On Tuesday, May 18, Roque says Foreign Secretary Teodoro Locsin Jr. is still allowed to speak about the West Philippine Sea since it is part of foreign policy. This means the gag order covers all other cabinet members, including Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana and National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon Jr., who've been vocal about the West Philippine Sea in the past. This is his second order to the cabinet on matters relating to China in 2 weeks. In early May, Duterte also ordered cabinet members not to use curse words when speaking about diplomatic concerns. Roque, who is not covered by the gag order, had mistakenly claimed that Julian Felipe Reef is not within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. The impeachment complaint against Supreme Court Associate Justice Marvick Leonen at the House of Representatives is now with the House Committee on Justice. The House of Representatives refers the impeachment complaint to the Justice Committee during its plenary on Tuesday, May 18. The committee will hold its own hearings to determine the form and substance of the impeachment complaint earlier flagged by legal luminaries as baseless. Under Section 3, Article 11 of the 1987 Constitution, the House of Representatives shall have the exclusive power to initiate all cases of impeachment. Ilocos Norte Representative Angelo Barba endorsed the impeachment complaint filed against Leonen. Barba is the cousin of defeated vice presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos. The complaint was filed after the Marcos camp failed to force Leonen to inhibit from the electoral protest case by Marcos against Vice President Lenny Robredo. Marcos lost the case in February 2021 when the Supreme Court dismissed the electoral protest. In a statement on Tuesday evening, House Majority Leader Martin Romualdez says he believes the Justice Committee lawmakers will act judiciously. Romualdez is also a cousin of Marcos. There's still no sign of a ceasefire as Israel continues to bombard Gaza with airstrikes and Palestinian militants keep up cross-border rocket fire. The attacks persist despite international calls to end more than a week of fighting, with Israeli leaders saying they are pressing on with an offensive against Hamas and Islamic Jihad. Two Thai workers are killed and seven people were wounded in a rocket strike on Tuesday, May 18, on an Israeli farm just over the Gaza border. Hamas and Islamic Jihad claim responsibility. 12 people were killed in Israel, while Gaza medical officials say a total of 217 Palestinians have been killed since fighting began May 10. Hamas began firing rockets 9 days ago in retaliation for what it said were Israeli rights abuses against Palestinians in Jerusalem during the Muslim holy month of Ramadan. Ben Platt reprises his role as Evan Hansen in the highly anticipated Dear Evan Hansen movie adaptation of the award-winning Broadway musical of the same name. In the trailer released by Universal Pictures Wednesday, May 19, Platt is heard singing the musical's breakout song, You Will Be Found. You can reach out your hand. The story follows Platt as Evan, a high school student with social anxiety, who gets caught in a lie when a letter he wrote to himself is found in the pocket of a classmate who died by suicide. The situation brings him closer to the departed's family. Platt tells Vanity Fair there are new scenes in the film adaptation that weren't seen in the musical. The Perks of Being a Wallflower's Steven Sposky will direct the adaptation. The Dear Evan Hansen musical won 6 Tony Awards, including Platt's win for Best Actor in a Musical. The film is slated to premiere on September 24, 2021.